Well, they have, no one gives a crap. This is my shot, I'm spending, I'm a fucking pay. What? Go to Salty. Oh, go to Fatal? Okay, I'm going to the big barn. Alright. Come invade my space, I dare ya. Seriously. No, I'm talking about someone else. Cause I freaking have a green revolver. Come on. When you switch to your guns, but you accidentally fire one. Ooh, a pistol. Okay. That was bad. Dude, I kind of have a problem. I'm right across from the big house. Trash. Duo. I have impulse nades. What? Just follow me.
What the money?
Okay, I already have a blue burst. They're in the house. I can see them. Yeah, they're shooting. Dude! I was outside. And come on. They're literally shooting it down. I need these nades. Nade. Deal. Okay, move. Okay. Very funny joke. I think they left. Yeah, they left. I'm looking.
Oh crap! Oh my god, he's sitting in the hot tub! What?
Wait, what?
He's sitting in the hot tub. No, I literally just walked in and he's sitting in the hot tub.
I deserve his loot.
What do you have?
I don't know, but I'll get the. Okay, let me see his loot. He had trash. He had one remote explosive. Yeah. Here's some light. Here's some medium. And here's some shells. No, I need it. I have a pistol. Okay. Do you need some bandages? No, you don't. Caleb, you had a good idea going to Fatal. Good. I got an elimination. Rushing was a good idea. When you could just... I need it for my pistol. I need it for my pistol. When I get a bunch of small ammo, I'll give it to you. Anyway, I only had 3 bullets. If you get a rocket launcher or a grenade launcher, hand it over. Because I have a bunch of, like, good stuff for it. And I'm the perfect rocket rider. Alright, I need to reload. Yo, they've been here. Yeah, that's where I'm going. All right. Now they always say congratulations. Vacation. Okay, I need materials, bro. Okay. Okay. I don't have a lot of ammo. I'm good. I mean, like, I don't want to take your ammo. Okay, they've been here. They checked it. Yeah, I need some shotgun. Wait. Can you stop, like, flexing on me with that skin? Hey! Okay, I have bandages! I'll just heal up in the open. When your blood ain't made that thing go grata da da. No, it just came on. Literally, I'm just playing on this like a... Okay, shotgun shells. I'm just playing a different like playlist in this. Let's go. A legendary hand cannon. If I got a chug jug, I would have drank it. Do you have any heavy bullets? Yep. Keep them until I need them. Okay, 33 people left. I'm wetting my lips because they're starting to get like trapped. Stop. Let me call up on the Uzi and show a man in a shot top. Okay, I got a big shield. I'm already drinking it. Okay. Like a pop star. What? There's only one. Hit it for the back, pulling it on a chest and that's just coming out of no mind. God damn it. Kiss that. Your wife is saying I'm looking like a whole snap. Need hundreds in my safe like a old rat. Yeah, I have some. Oh. Okay, these people were nice. I don't like this. I'm way ahead of you. I don't like this. But I'm way ahead of you. I could easily just, like, get killed, and then they're gonna finish me because you're not over here. Yo, I see some peeps. Dude, hurry up. Hurry up. Get up here. We gotta run. Yo! I just got sniped at. Oh no, I think it came from back here. Yeah, it came from back there. It came from back there. It came from back there. Just in case. Dude, come in. Come in, come in. Come on, come on. No. Yo, no, no, no. No! How did you get me? Oh my god, it wouldn't let me move. That's too stupid. I don't want a doctor in the mess. God's plan. Hi. Well, get ready, bro.
I'm 3 tiers away.
Wait a minute. No, there we go. Get ready, bro. Does your friend have the battle pass?
Yeah.
Then we should all be Rust Lords.
Oh, yeah, that'll be funny.
I'll
be...
Yeah. Now they always say congratulations. What? It's on my playlist. No. I don't have to get anything off my playlist.
Look, I got gun show, guys.
Good for you. Damn it. Okay, this is a different song. Okay, Pleasant. I'm going to the middle of Pleasant.
Wait, tree houses.
Wait, tree house? Oh.
I'm gonna go right here. No one come to my factory. This is my factory right here.
Where?
Right here.
You said we're going to Pleasant.
I know, I'm going to my factory.
That's not Pleasant.
Yeah, technically it is.
What are you doing? Give me my phone! Please? Oh my god! I'm playing in a game!
You understand what I'm saying?
I don't even have a gun yet! I don't even have a gun, so I can't even come save you. Oh. Okay, I'm coming.
They're gonna kill me!
I'm coming! Where are they? Haha. Yo, I knocked him.
I'm coming, Did you have freaking...
Not the first time. I had an RPG.
So I'm feeling like I'm over it.
Where is he?
Next. Dude, come on. This is why I don't like playing with y'all.
Figure out what we want to do. Because that's why I got married at first sight. I wanted to spend the rest of my life with someone. Like, I wanted someone
scares me about having children is I'm very protective over my loved ones. Like, I don't want anybody talking about them. I don't want nobody hurting them. I don't want nobody, like, I'm just like, I know, but it just, it scares me. Like, and then them growing up, anything happens.
Slack. Just give me anything. Don't be alone. Don't be anything.
I think Ryan has been so scared of losing himself and losing his time with his friends and everything that he loves and cherishes to having a wife. And it's not allowing for me to come in fully. And it scares me that I might not fit into Ryan's life or that he's not going to make room for me because I don't know where the relationship's going to go. Sometimes if I need you and I'm sick and like after a day like this, it's also stressful for me. Like, I need you. Like, I need you. Like, I also need you. And I know that you're concerned that I'm not going to give you slack, but I don't know how, like, how, if you need so much slack where you are just, like, not involved with somebody, then that's not even a relationship. I don't understand. Do you want slack or do you not want to be married?
Define grab. Express yourself. Grab stylist shape and fill pencil by L'Oreal. The easy-to-use triangular tip shapes and fills. The Ubi Brush Blend.
Grab palette.
Grab
what I want to do while I have
to. Unless it affects our relationship.
Well,
it's not judging you, it's just trying to figure out us. Like, you need to go out and drink anymore? Like, you need to.
Ryan and Jacqueline are struggling because Jacqueline wants Ryan to be home and be a husband, but Ryan wants to be one of the boys, even though now he's going to be married. And that's concerning because once you're married, your responsibilities change. Your wife is your priority. The boys are secondary.
It's unproductive what we're doing right now. We're arguing with you just to argue.
Would you think there's not a solution to last year? Like, do you think that if that was to happen again, because I'm certain now, it will. So what do we do if something like that comes up again? These arguments like tonight and last night are not my ideal vision of marriage. I want to be with someone who wants to come home with me and wants to be with me.
The solution is either I stay home and don't go out, and the other solution is you say, okay, call me later, like, let me know, like, what's up, stay in touch, and I never keep you in the dark about anything.
I guess it just takes time. We'll just see. Like, we just have to figure it out.
But the way
it was handled last night was wrong. And I don't want that to happen because that's not a marriage. That's not even a relationship to me. It just is toxic.
Ryan needs to figure out what he wants out of this marriage and determine whether or not he's ready to fulfill another person's need. Because marriage is not something to be open to. You have to know what you want.
I'm sorry for, you know, me not staying home while you were sick, and sorry for going out, and I want to just prove to you that, like, I'm in this marriage 100%, even though you might not think that that's the case, and they're right, I do need to step it up and do better. My vision of marriage is definitely two people that can coexist through the good times and the bad times, and I want this relationship to last forever, so I'm taking the faith, and I'm going to listen to Pastor Cal's advice, and take that loss, baby, because I want this girl to be my wife, like, for, you know, for as long as I'm on this earth. If we're going to make it, we're going to have to get better, and we're going to have to understand each other better.
Marriage is everything I've always wanted, so if this doesn't work out, I will be devastated. But I do see a light at the end of the tunnel with Ryan, and I see us working towards that. And I know it hasn't been the picture-perfect marriage, but I really do think that because we do keep coming back to each other and we still look at each other the same, and after these interviews we still hold each other the same, I do think that there's a lot of hope that the marriage does work.
Ready.
Oh,
God.
Oh, God.
Galaxy Forever, you can upgrade to the newest Galaxy every year. It's like pre-ordering for the future.
Upgrades every year.
Every year.
Upgrades every year.
Every year.
Every year.
Every year.
Upgrades every year.
Every year. Upgrades every year.
Yes, every year. How come no one's getting it?
Who's Samsung Galaxy S9 and get a second on Sprint? And with Galaxy Forever, always have the newest Galaxy.
This couple met on a pay dating site. Jen and Luke met for free on Plenty of Fish. Happy couple. Happy couple. Why pay to meet someone? Plenty of Fish. Simple, free, and works.
You can do it.
I'm not surprised. Shawty's been playing something that would make me feel completely uncomfortable, the way out of my comfort zone, but for her, I'll give it a shot.
It was surprising because I thought he was going to not want to do it, but he did it. I'm very proud of him, and I'm happy that he's done it, and it just shows me that he is involved in, and I think it's kind of sexy that he is trying new things and stepping outside of his comfort zone, and I'm really proud of him for that.
Join us to help millions in crisis heal their skin.
question more. You were, and I'm like, what really matters to me? Like, what matters is, are we getting along? And, you know, giving certain things up have to happen to have like, a successful marriage. It's not very easy, but.
It's just like figuring out, yeah, what works best for each other.
I got married at first sight to actually be 100% devoted and committed to this one person and have us both feel like, you know, definitely 100% positive that we're going to stick it through no matter what and be each other's like rock. And I have that with Jackie. So I'm hopeful for the future because I know that we have such more room to grow in this marriage. And I'm very hopeful I'm going to fall in love with Jackie one day.
What's been your favorite, like, part of that marriage so far? Happiest moment.
My happiest moment after seeing you walk down the aisle was, you know, getting to know you a little bit and getting to know your family and kind of like going through this whole roller coaster. I'm still sitting next to you and my hands are up in the air and I'm enjoying the ride.
It's kind of like this where I see amazing glimpses of hope with Ryan and I because he's so caring and can tell that he wants it for us, and it's just not always the easiest for him to express or show, especially after hard times, but he hasn't given up. So I feel like there is definitely glimpses of Ryan and I falling in love and feeling positive about the direction that we're going in, and it's going to be something I think that will last forever.
Good thing.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Three more.
I am still in youth, it's just my joints,
yeah,
as such.
You better utilize this year and find yourself in your 20s. Well, you know, just get the most out of it. Just get the most out of
it. Once you turn 30, it's all downhill, John.
That's all I see. Today is John's birthday, so I'm taking him out because I want him to know that I'm thinking about our relationship and him as a person. And I really hope that he has a good night.
Yeah. Not you just a little something.
Husband. It's my first birthday as a married man, and in the marriage, you kind of want somebody that pays attention in the small moments that you don't think they'll listen. And she gives me a gift card that she knows is my favorite store, so it definitely shows that she listens, and that really makes me excited.
Our relationship and our future together.
I've never been in a relationship where I've been able to communicate with somebody so easily.
Yeah, we both have the same end goal, so then you're both
trying to figure out how to make the relationship work.
Yeah. You don't feel like you're against each other.
Right.
I'm definitely all in this marriage. And I'm really trying to go outside of my comfort zone and just show John affection. Because I definitely see a future with him. And I think that John really has the potential to be the love of my life.
I'd say we're so fresh. Plus my wife's the eyes.
I think I'm the best husband to
her.
I am definitely all in.
Next time on Married at First Sight, with less than 3 weeks before final decision, our couples learn the importance of getting on the same page about their expectations for marriage.
I made spaghetti the other night.
You could get in the same pot?
Yes.
But that's wrong.
I literally found myself taking him out of my sauce all the time.
And she wants me to live in my own apartment?
Does she respect you?
If she doesn't, then no, it's not going to work out. Honest to God.
Baby. She feels weird right now because it's totally true.
That's not good. Don't try to keep my hate.
Welcome to my life.
Fall in love at Niagara Falls.
What the hell? That's awesome, dude.
My name is Stephanie. I'm 29 years old.
Oh my god.
love and ready for marriage.
Ready?
We're surveyed and evaluated by our expert matchmaker to create four perfectly matched couples.
I'm excited. I'm nervous. At this point in my life where I'm up for anything.
Now it's up to them to make it work while traveling across the country in a 30-day journey packed with relationship challenges, rewards, and more baggage than they can carry.
Get to the hotel soon. We'll be one day closer to finding out.
Their last destination, the altar, where the couples decide if it really was love at first sight.
I kind of feel like I want to throw up.
I am here to get it right. I want a matchmaker because I'm not attracting the right people. I've been in really, really bad relationships. I was in a 7-year relationship with this guy that I thought I was going to marry, and just one day I found out that he was cheating on me, and I called up all the girls and basically said, you know, this guy tells me he wants to marry me every single day, and you are not the only girl that is sending him naked pictures. It was traumatic, but even after the whole ordeal, I now know what I want, and I'm not going to settle. I'm a wedding singer, so I see weddings every single weekend. God, you can just see, when two people are in love, I just want it.
Can't believe I'm about to meet my wife like this. With this opportunity that's in front of me, I wanted to give it my all and my 100%. So with that being said, been working a lot on myself this past year or so and really doing some, soul searching, whatever you want to call it, to make sure that I'm really finding the genuine me and then I can share that with someone else. If things go amazing, maybe I could actually have what I've been looking for, and that's a win.
This is crazy.
This is actually you?
Yeah.
You're way too beautiful. You look amazing.
Roses, those are my favorite.
Yes, they're for you.
And I'm looking at him and I'm like, oh my God, you are so handsome and you have roses in your hands. Those are my favorite flowers.
Well, that's for you.
Ryan. My brother's name.
No way.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Hi.
My first impression of Steph is that she's very gorgeous, very energetic and happy and good vibes are coming off her.
Yeah.
Wait, are you kidding me? You're from New York?
Yes.
Oh my God. I had a freaking dream the other night that you were from New York. I'm not joking. That I couldn't see your face or anything, but nope.
Oh my God, yeah.
So it's kind of meant to be. It's so weird.
Nothing, you know about me? I sang in the wedding band?
Yes, singer. Beautiful voice. Awesome.
What about you?
I am actually currently, I wouldn't say homeless because I moved back with my parents because I took a leave for my work. So
okay.
I'm basically chilling right now. I actually went on a leave of absence just recently with General Motors. I took this opportunity pretty seriously, and the fact that I left my job and moved out of my apartment means that so I was ready to leave and go wherever I needed to go to meet my wife.
So why are you doing this?
In early 2016, I got sick. Pericarditis is what I had, and they compare the symptoms to a heart attack, and so I really thought I was dying. I turned my thinking around. I am at a crossroads right now. I'm ready for a change. There's never been a time more than right now where I've probably been more prepared to do something like this, and there's never a better opportunity than what's standing right in front of me right now, so.
That's a good answer. Who are you? Is this real?
Are you real?
Couples were matched based on an overwhelmingly high percentage of compatibility marks.
Gotta check my phone. So it's time to get up close and personal. Your accommodations for this evening will depend upon how wet you're willing to get.
What?
To test that compatibility, couples are given challenges, pushing them to rely upon one another, work together, communicate, and build an instant rapport, the building blocks of a successful marriage. Where things go from there is up to them.
We're gonna get pretty wet, I feel like.
Alright. Come here. At least let's get some alone time. Alright? Oh, you're nervous. That's what it is, huh?
I want to have someone to spend the rest of my life with. So I'm 31 now. So it's alright, clock's kicking, man. I've been in three significant relationships. The last relationship, we had been dating for about a year. That was real love. Like, she really loved me. She really did. She had epilepsy, so she had a seizure. She's had seizures before. This time I wasn't there. She actually passed away.
You have a nice
and that was like one of the hardest things I've ever had to do in my life. I'm thankful for the matchmaker because they really tell you about yourself. You're like, you really know me. Hopefully, fingers crossed, my dreams come true.
Religion is huge to me. Jesus, he's my homie. That's that. And absolutely, the person that I'm dating has to be on the exact same level. I'm in a great place in life. I just really want to share it with someone who's equally as excited and awesome.
If any opportunity comes, like, I prayed over it, and I was just like, it wouldn't come to me if, you know, if it wasn't for me to do. So, take life by the horns.
Oh, is that her? Oh, that is her. Okay.
Smiles for life.
You have to turn everything into a meme. I think it's just a lot of
people were there that would define her life. She attended the University of Notre Dame and was named Outstanding Senior. After graduating from SMU Law School, Dale earned a reputation as a tough criminal prosecutor, competent civil attorney, and dedicated clerk of court. Now, she'll bring that same work ethic to our Court of Appeal. Dale Atkins, Court of Appeal.
My family's opinion of John is very important to me. We feel bad about it halfway through. It's just so hard to tell the people we have to that we. I really have no idea what I'm going to decide decision day.
God, I'm so nervous. I feel like I'm ready for the right relationship now because I'm at the point in my life where I have a good job, I have everything going for me, so why settle down? There's a huge epidemic with divorce, people getting married for the wrong reasons, and I don't want to be another statistic. My parents separated, so it's like, oh, well, maybe I shouldn't put all my love and energy into somebody because they're just going to leave, and this is why I wanted this whole process, to have the matchmaker, so maybe a third party will get it right for me.
This, to me, is the most beautiful thing I've ever done. To put yourself in someone else's hands and say, hey, they chose this guy for you.
But I really believe in this matchmaker, and I honestly believe she has my husband waiting for me.
Oh, my God. Okay. Stop it. He's there. I see him. He's stylish.
He looks like Prince Charming. The height, his presence, his posture. He looks great. Like, how I like it. Very stylish.
And as you get close, my heart's like, bump. I'm like, steady your breathing. Don't be that weird, crazy guy waiting for you, like, swinging a flower around. Hello?
Hi, how are you?
Nervous, how are you?
Yeah,
nice to meet you.
I need to move on with my life. It was was definitely hurtful. I very much want to find the right woman for me to get married. I'm ready to take that next step.
Hello.
Hi.
Jenna.
Hi, Jenna.
Nice to meet you.
Kale.
Hi, Kale.
Yeah.
Like, okay. Like the car.
Exactly. Oh, with a C instead of a K. Yeah. My dad's a big NASCAR fan, so I'm actually named after a NASCAR driver, Kale Yarbrough. He's in the Hall of Fame now. But, yeah. What do you do?
The last 2 years I've been teaching kindergarten.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Do you like working with kids?
I do. I also like going home to a quiet house. But during the day, yeah, they're a lot of fun.
Oh, nice.
How about you?
I'm an attorney.
An attorney?
Yeah.
Sounds very stressful and serious.
I do litigation, so I'm in the courtrooms a lot.
Okay, good to know in case I can help with something.
Exactly.
Did I get in trouble?
Exactly. Yeah, I was a little...
I'm a good girl. No trouble with the law yet. I want to know what we're doing, don't you?
Well, I got this package last night. It says, we open together. Well,
is what we're doing?
Okay. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Looks like there's a map in here.
Oh, God.
Map of Manhattan.
That's the joke. I don't read maps.
Okay. New York City food tour. The menu.
And we have a checklist.
At least one of you must try to provide a dish at each restaurant.
That's okay. You?
I got it.
The more adventurous your taste bud, the better your accommodation for this evening. I'm not very adventurous with food, though.
You're not?
Sample all four dishes by five, and you'll be sharing a romantic dessert in a suite at the Avalon Hotel. Fail in the food won't be the only thing you're apprehensive about. Wow.
Don't worry, I got this.
Okay.
That's what this is about.
I am fearless in direction. This is a joke.
I got it. Okay, so we should probably try to find these places right now while we're here.
I can't believe you're actually looking at a map.
I can tell that he's a very organized, checkmark type of guy.
So here's Times Square.
Is that where we are?
Yeah.
He's more pool-oriented. He likes to make plans. He's more on top of it. Directions, stuff like that.
We got West 50th Street.
I don't normally date pool-oriented guys, which is a problem. So I like that he's pool-oriented. I do.
Okay, so the first place is on 50th Street.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're on One Right Street, so let's
do it. Right from the get-go, we were challenged with trying to locate the restaurants that we were going to. So far, I've learned that Jenna doesn't like to read maps, but that's okay. I'm willing to do that. So, we're looking for 251 West 50th Street.
I saw like 16-something, so we are far off.